Whatever.
Hi Playmates, it's Aerostar. Let's get down to the top updates for the Exos Heroes game this week. But before we begin, if you haven't, please make sure that you have used the new coupon code FLOWER to claim your 200 Zest before it's too late. I'll go ahead and leave a link down below where you can enter your airship information to claim this prize. So I'm only going to be covering like the big basics here in this update and not including things like the 7 days of gifts and the premium recruit that you should definitely pick up on a daily basis before the month is over, as well as like the family packages, so go ahead and check those out in the links that I will quest up below. So there's actually quite a lot of different changes that are happening this week, but the first one, probably on the top of the list, is that FC Sabrina, the blue fake court that was just recently released, is getting nerfed again already. Alright, so it looks like the maximum fusion attack increase is going to be 6.3%, dropped all the way down from the original 15, but to compensate for the change, they are going to give us a refund for up to 40 pulls in the next 1.5 weeks. The banner has been extended for another 1.5 weeks, and also that we will get up to 40 pulls of that in a refund after the event ends. Now, it does seem like if you had pulled more than 40 times before this extension, you will be getting a full refund for that. It also seems like if you had used the station to buy the Zest, you will also be getting a refund back for that as well. If you'd like to find out how many pulls you've already done, you can go in and send an inquiry and they say they will get back to you, but we'll just have to see how much that actually helps. So in the end, it did cause a little bit of trouble with all these nerfing and things like that, and there were a lot of talks about how they should check their games, but I do feel like it's kind of hard to kind of really know what all these changes are going to really not modify and change. And so them giving a sort of a compensation, I think, is a step in the right direction and something definitely not to get too mad about. So if you haven't pulled for FC Sabrina already, I do recommend going ahead and doing so. Now please keep in mind that Zest rewards will come after this banner ends, so that means that if we have any other banners in between, that you probably will not be getting the Zest back for that. So just keep that in mind if you're pulling for, which is the next news of the Choice Faker Re-Blue Recruit System. So we have the first of their implementation of ways that players can get more blue fake cores that provides buffs to like entirety group of heroes. So for this next update from April 29th to May 6th, we'll be able to choose from the 5 main blue fake cores: Raquel, Topaki, Baraka, Yao, and Aiden. So in this case, if you have Zest and you have a certain nation that you want to buff up, I would definitely go ahead and try to pull for these. Now they do say that they will implement monthly events regarding the blue fake core, so we'll have to go ahead and see about that. But again, the fusion stat bonuses for these nations are pretty good, especially if you only have only one copy, so you definitely should go for it. Like I for one will probably be going for Raquel because I currently only have one copy of this blue fake core, and I have been kind of establishing my Lenombre team, so I am definitely going to be pulling for him even without the Zest compensation that's been rolling in. So rolling along with the theme of fake cores, we now are going to have fake core memories. So not only just hero memories, we'll now have fake core memories with the ability to also share them in the air squadron. So this means that now if you collect enough memory fragments, you will also get a fake core without the copy of the hero. So this makes it interesting because now that we get fake core copies, we will be able to equip that onto the hero, but remember you still need a copy of the hero and the fake core if you want to fusion any of the fake core, so you gotta just keep that in mind that the system will only allow you to go ahead and pull a fake core copy and not the hero copy. This is the same for the Dora Creation Fake Recruit Craftbook update, where we will be able to fuse two blue or gold fake cores, as well as fusing two black fake cores to get another black fake core. We will not be getting copies of the heroes along with this feature, so we will actually need to be keeping copies of the base heroes if we decide to go ahead and try to use these new fake core recruitment features. So this means that, for example, if you want to not have another copy of black fake core Annie, you're going to have to keep copies of the base Annie in order to equip the fake core if you happen to get enough memories of her or happen to fuse her together in the Dora creation. The third update is the ability to reset our unleashed potential. As we kind of have projected, we will be needing a new currency called the Reversion Clockwork in order to reset it. We'll be getting one for free along with the update, but it is very vague about how we can actually get keys, reversion clockwork. The one thing that is certain that is that it will be available in the store to purchase for real money. It does say that we'll be able to get them through events and stuff like that, but how rare this will be, we'll have to find out soon. But again, this allows you to go ahead and reset all your unleashed potential for a particular hero, so you will get the orbs back so that you can go ahead and transfer it onto a different hero of your choosing. You should note that the original 30 zest to open the unleashed potential for each of the heroes will probably not be refunded in this process, so you still need to discern a little bit about which hero that you want to start to unleash so that you don't have to use that extra zest for any heroes that you don't plan on using in the near future. The next update has to do with the cosmetics. I really can't leave this out. It looks like Tira's Dye Station is also once again upgraded so that you can now change the posture of your heroes there. So I do believe that changing the posture here will also change it in like the hero screen and also in the airship, hopefully crossing your fingers, but it does allow us to go in and change that there, so it's another cute feature. And not to mention the orange FC Degas is now available. You do have to spend real life money and charge crystals in order to get him, but he does look pretty cool and I think I probably will grab him just because, you know, Degas again was my first husbando in the game. He is currently running around in his swimwear, which does look pretty cool, but I think this new knight to cover him up is actually going to be pretty good for him too, so I will be probably picking that up in order to get a purchase of the new core raid pass, which is now happening for the black and white fate core, as well as the new exiles pass as well. And last but not least, the new chapter 18 is going to be Field. I didn't do a chapter 17 story because there actually wasn't too much that was going on there, just like the whole escape thing that's happening with Nemarius tagging up with Iris and her gang in order to try to save Zeon. Now at the very end, it looks like Zeon just came out and something's about to happen, so hopefully chapter 18 will show us a little bit more action into what's gonna happen as the gang tried to escape from Saint West and being covered for the murder of Queen Carrie. Again, I'm still waiting for that whole war scene that we've been teased about. Hopefully gonna happen soon, hopefully gonna happen fast, we get that whole scenario, but let's look up to that. Besides that, the last update is that they are adding a bunch of UI changes, so now we get to see all different types of boss set presets for the Zenbenster and things like that. If you're interested in learning a little bit more, I will add links to the actual full updates down below so you could go ahead and check them out yourself. Which update are you guys most excited about? Let me know in the comments below. And if you like random gaming content, especially on Exos Heroes, please consider leaving a like and subscribing. I post every Wednesday and weekends. Thank you all so much for watching. Stay safe and take care.